Thank you very much. I give immediately the microphone to Felicia Pontis. Felicina Pontis, she works at the Memoriale Sardo della Shoah. It's a primary school teacher, obtained her master's degree both from Istituto Superiore di Scienze Religiose and from La Sapienza University here in Rome. And she works all, she makes a lot of things. She works also on kosher lifestyle and relation between the Jewish cuisine and some pathologies solutions. And he wished to speak to us about the relation between population from two islands, Rhodes and Sardinia. And okay, it's you to speak.
Good afternoon. Vorrei, scusate la presentazione in italiano, perché volevo fare dei ringraziamenti speciali prima di tutto a tutti voi. Grazie perché sono qua, sono molto felice. Poi ho due ringraziamenti speciali da fare, una Sandra Terracina, che è qui presente, la ringrazio per la sua presenza, e l'altro è al mio professore, il mio docente universitario della Sapienza, dell'Università della Sapienza, nonché il mio relatore, il professor Camplani, che si trova alla mia sinistra, e che sarà anche il mio prossimo relatore della mia prossima tesi, visto che quest'anno mi iscrivo. Visto che siamo in un periodo di europei di calcio, quando si trova un ottimo CT non lo si cambia, non lo si cede a nessuno, e quindi la mia prossima tesi la discuterò sicuramente con lui. E volevo anche anticipare, vedrete delle immagini che non si trovano in nessun testo, perché ho utilizzato del materiale che è in possesso del signor Dessy, quindi ho utilizzato il suo materiale della sua, diciamo così, del suo archivio personale, in quanto sono le mie ricerche post-tesi, che sarà un argomento sicuramente della mia tesi successiva, e quindi è un materiale inedito che presento e che, ripeto, non si trovano in nessun testo. Quindi parlerò appunto dei rapporti fra gli ebrei e la comunità sarda a Rodi. Vi è anche un'unica foto in cui è presente mia mamma e parte della sua famiglia, in quanto per una scelta personale la famiglia di mia mamma non vuole parlare, quindi fa silenzio, e il materiale non lo posso utilizzare, per cui io utilizzo quello che ho e continuo con le mie ricerche. Grazie. Allora, Jewish and Sardinian communities at Rhode Island. Rhode had been under the Ottoman Empire for a long time without any economical and cultural boosting. Rhode's failing and following annexion by Italy, which took place in 1912, involved greater huge change within the management and organizational structure of the island. During the fascist period, 1922-1943, it was difficult to find a job, and the government exploited the immigration route to houses reputed Italian possession because they won the war. However, it was not the case. In the 30s, as a result of a tension between Greece and the Italian Duce Mussolini, the Italian present grew up either for the soldier and civilians. The Italian population in the island increased with the immigrations coming from three Italian regions, specifically Trentino Alto Adige, Sardinia, and Campania. Italian immigrants were mostly skilled in agriculture. In this context, I would like to highlight the history of Mr. Guido Francesco de Sy de Liperi. Il signore che vedrete è sempre signor De Sy, ma è il genero. Avevano lo stesso cognome. Quello che vedrete è Mario, che mi ha raccontato la storia, mentre colui che ha fatto arrivare i suoi compaesani era il suocero, che invece era Guido Francesco. Quindi due persone con lo stesso cognome. Who are common between the Jewish and the Sardinia communities in Rhodes, specifically Miss Maria Bonaria Pisu, whose life will be further discussed. Mr. De Sy was one of a few lucky folks able to graduate in agriculture. For this reason, the enmity of colonists within the fascist government sent Mr. De Sy to the territories of Rome, Poland, Albania, and the Benghazi, as a subject matter expert in agriculture, including to supervise the agriculture in the Rhode Island. He made a lot of important friends, such as fascist politicians, including Cesare Balbo, Mario Lago, the governor in Rhodes, and the deposed Girolamo Soggiu and Bianca. He built up several villages held on the east coast for the Italian community, especially for Sardinians, thus calling several families from Settimo San Pietro, his native village in Sardinia. Those people were well skilled as plant breeders and farmers. Miss Maria Bonaria Pisu was one of above mentioned families. Mr. De Sy was surrounded from trustable people, homed at modernizing the island, which had been abandoned from the Ottoman Empire for more than five century years. His most reliable guy was Mr. Kasdai Kazan, a Jew with Tarkin origin. A further phase of fascist governance consolidated the acquisition of the Dodecaneso Island. This generated multiple sub-governors with several competences based on individual skills. Population was predominantly consist of Greek Orthodox and Jewish ethnic groups, which were different because the Greek group had a low cultural level, with the Jewish community was high educated. The Jewish presence in the island lasted roughly four centuries, and the new administration was looking from local Jewish as a great opportunity to approach the modern European culture. Further Jewish integration within the Italian community made the Greek disappointed in regard to the new political order. This is the transfer from Settimo San Pietro to Rhodi, and this is the original journal Il Messaggero di Rhodi, che fa parte proprio dell'archivio di signor Mario De Sy e che apparteneva al suocero. In that era context, education represented a huge weight in terms of remarkable investment on Italian schools, which raised the quality of basic education with multiple efforts, such as replacing Greek language with literacy training and the general culturing in Italian language. First, this common cultural activity consolidated solidarity among Jewish and Italian communities. Initially, Mario Lago governed the Aegean island in the time frame 1923-1936. He pushed to encourage the development of the island, making progresses and prosperity. Lago respected and safeguarding the rights of local people and ethnic minorities, promoting happy coexistence between Greek, Italians, Turks, Armenian, and Jewish, without remarking the weight of Italy as colonial rule. In the 1936, Mr. Cesare Maria De Vecchi took over as governor till 1940. He was an enthusiastic supporter of a new fascist doctrine opting for a policy opposite to the predecessor. Mr. De Vecchi's speeches were always upsetting in regard to the Jewish community. He also transferred the Jewish cemetery from Judaria to a suburban area in order to completely transform the Judaria area, which had been a place with a square lared in, on a medieval castle, representing a cultural homogeneity to the broken according to the De Vecchi plans. De Vecchi constituted new construction, specifically a new school, which interrupted the physical and the common cultural age amongst the Italian and the Jewish community. Questa è la foto di cui vi parlavo, il signor appunto Dessì, con Mario Lago e Cesare Maria De Vecchi, era una sorta di ministro dell'agricoltura. E quindi questa è una foto proprio dei primi anni 30. De Vecchi constituted a new, despite the fact that the co-present of Italian students, Greek and the Jewish, made very close Italian and the Jewish Greek, did not apply in the same manner, it might be due to the mandatory language to be used. The harmony on the Jewish Italians was also favored by the cultural homogeneity, in detail the commonality between Italian and the Jewish Sephardic culture. Latin was the main language of the Jewish of Rhodes, and Spanish native language with insert of Hebrew word and idiom Mediterranean. However, Jewish of Rhodes were multilingual. They also knew Greek, Spanish, French, Turkish, and Italian language. Although the culture and the religion difference tended to create some distances between Orthodox and the Catholic, especially within the school system, the common Mediterranean matrix made very positive relationship among the families. There was a great cohesion among children, also the physical opening of the houses allowed to move along difference, whereas all the children were well accepted within the different communities. During the holidays given by each religion, the other communities actively participated, making a strong sense of solidarity. The proximity between the various groups and the solidarity was shown in the relationship between children and the youth who used to go to the common place and the school, and the sharing common experience despite of having different origin, language, and religion customs. Also, some were absent from the groups of the peers on Friday, Saturday, or Sundays, due to religion reasons, it does not trigger any kind of exclusion of reaction from others. Even mixed marriages were very usual, also apparently opposite for religion reason. Also, the cohesion between the Catholic and the Jewish as a result of the great management of the Governor Lago. This close relationship between the Sardinian people and the Jewish in Rhodes appeared to renew the past close relation, interrupted in 1492 when the Jewish community was expelled from Sardinia after a law edited by the Spanish monarchs Isabella and Ferdinando of Aragon and Castilla. Questa è un'altra ricerca che sto diciamo intraprendendo per verificare se fra gli ebrei di Rodi ci fossero dei discendenti che provenivano dalla Sardegna, quindi un'altra relazione che può esserci fra la Sardegna e il mondo ebraico, la comunità ebraica. In the 1936, a significant tragedy happened with the introduction of racial laws. The Jews of Rhodes, who previously felt as Italians, were totally unprepared and offended from the introduction of racial laws against them. Jewish were unable to carry out any job in that era, except small businesses. It didn't help the dramatic economic situation triggered from the isolation, which made almost impossible to supply food. In fact, the Nazi invaders were no longer able to distinguish between the two realities after the armistice signed the 8th of September 1943. Although the Jewish of Rhodes were forced to massively go to the palace of the Italian Air Force on the 12 July 1944, for identification purposes, the apparent assumed status was suddenly interrupted by a detention for a few days. Then Jewish were sent to the port, saying it was not allowing them to establish any contact with the local population. Questa data è anche molto particolare per me, perché appunto parlo di una storia familiare, in quanto mia mamma è venuta a mancare il giorno che finalmente aveva deciso di recarsi a Rodi, come in questa data, che è stranamente anche la data del compleanno di Sami Modiano. Quindi ci sono tante cose, insomma, che così mi accomunano al mondo ebraico. During this sad and confused period, some relevant characters, both Italian and German, strove and left for the special case in attempts to save human lives. Queste sono immagini della comunità sarda ed ebraica a Rodi. For instance, since Mr. Guido Francesco de Cid de Liperi, who regardless for risks, issued a special pass to his best friends, Kasdai Kazan, in order to allow him to leave the island, so saved his life. Mr. Gerolamo Soggio, former teacher in the local Italian school, which was first suddenly and then arrested and tortured by the Germans for his anti-fascist ideas. He made almost the impossible to help the Jewish in that difficult moment, for example, teaching to the boys spelling from school in accordance with the racial laws established in the 1930. Anche Gerolamo Soggio con la moglie erano appunto provenienti dalla Sardegna e hanno dato un grande supporto alla comunità sarda, quindi sono appunto inseriti in quel contesto di una relazione fra la comunità sarda e quindi quella ebraica a Rodi. The same, his wife Bianca Soggio became the protagonist of a very touching event, the assistance given to a woman in a labor. Already in prison situation just before the deportation, Mrs. Soggio managed to bring to the hospital. The island of Rhodes was not immune in regard to the counter-Judaism of the traditional Semitic stemming from fascist and Nazi politicians. Also, Rhodes sadly contributed in terms of victim. Yet, although the fascist governors' attitudes were extremely contradictory and, in a first step, even pro-Jewish and the worsening of the anti-Semitic attitudes on the part of the fascist governorate apparent with the passing of the culminating with the Nazi occupation of Rhodes and the deportation of the Jewish living there. The communities in Rhodes reacted in a different manner for this crime against the humanity. They acted in different ways. Someone was collaborating, others were neutral. Someone else established ed hidden strong college resistance. The almost painful and sad story of the Holocaust victim is linked to unlucky Sardinian settlers who are still unknown. Only the proper seeking information and the retrieval of documents about these people and a related story allow it to discover not the famous realities existed some years ago. Questa è l'unica foto che ho di mia mamma a Rodi, qui c'è parte della sua famiglia. Questa pare sia la sua casa. Quando sono stata a Rodi abbiamo fatto delle ricerche con una storica Evangelia Panarion che un mese fa circa mi ha detto che probabilmente abbiamo trovato la casa dei miei genitori, di mia mamma, non di mia mamma e della sua famiglia paterna, nei pressi di Villa Pascià, nella costa orientale dell'isola. Diciamo che il villaggio era intorno, era vicino, diciamo, a Villa Pascià. The most only the proper seeking information and retrieval of documents about these people and the reality story allowing the discover not famous reality existence some years ago. The archival result bring me to continue my personal documentary research to write and share in memory still unknown to most of us. Many Sardini included the father of Maria Bonaria, che è questo. Who traveled to Rhodes, the whole Pisu family with 8 children from Settimo San Pietro. E qui non ci sono tutti i miei zii, ce n'è appunto una parte. Vediamo, ci sono soltanto 3 zii e mia mamma, quindi 5 zii, quindi mancano 3 della 3 componenti della famiglia di mia mamma. Pisu children once adult found a job enjoying prosperity. The older sister married with a Sardinian boy. The little Maria Bonaria di Paola, her sister, spent an idyllic childhood. Questo è il viaggio che hanno effettuato i sardi, quindi dalla Sardegna a Rodi, quindi un viaggio abbastanza lungo, soprattutto per quei tempi. Questo è il signor Mario Dessì. Con parte dell'archivio, del suo archivio personale che apparteneva appunto al suocero. E queste sono le immagini che provengono dal suo archivio. Questo è l'indirizzo di Kasdai Kazan che è stato salvato appunto dal suocero con un lasciapassare. Questa è la Vittorio Levi con la storica Evangelia Panarion. For the children, it was a trauma to see the sky that used to be blue. Became gray fond many planes that were flying around Rodi to destroy the island. Maria Bonaria did not see longer her friend, her Jewish friend Lucia, the only friend. They started to feel sad and the more thinner because on the back, the lack of food. Rodi was surrounded by the English many and nobody could arrive in the island. Lucia used to tell that it was impossible to go to school and that it was forbidden for them to enter some shop and offices. They could not take the bus and the public transport. One day, Lucia said to her best friend Maria Bonaria that they will not to see each other any longer, that they could not play today anymore, and gave her a pendant that Maria Bonaria kept daily and took with her in Sardinia. Even after she was taken to the concentration camp in the island. After her way back in Sardinia, 1 year after her time spent in the camp, Maria Bonaria became a wife and a mom, and they used to tell every day her story, and the story to her best Jewish friend, to her daughter, the same girl that today witness to her story. Finito. Ok. Concludo dicendo che appunto ok. Questa storia, insomma, la sto ancora sto cercando di riassemblarla e di ricostruirla, quindi questo in sintesi, insomma, l'amicizia tra mia mamma e questa bambina di cui non si sa niente, non so neanche il cognome, e quindi sto cercando di riassemblare appunto questa storia di questa amicizia e di tante altre storie che riguardano appunto le relazioni fra gli ebrei e i sardi a Rodi. Grazie.
Thank you. Sorry to be I don't know what is the English word, to be a little cerbero. I don't know how to translate. We will do another workshop about Cerbero and his friends. So, please, we need your comments, your questions, your on both the papers.
I want to recall that in 2014 our center in Milano produced a film on Rhodos Jews named The Last Journey, Rhodos Auschwitz. I want to underline that this is an important document. The film was turned in the Jewish quarter of Rhodos with three survivors. Alberto Israel, who lives in Bruxelles, Sami Modiano, who lives in Rome, and Stella Levy, who lives in New York. And they tell us their childhood, their dreams, their hopes, their Jewish culture, their arrest and deportation to the Auschwitz-Birkenau, and their deception toward that attitude of the Greek population of the island, who plundered their belongings when they left to Poland, and their love towards the Italian culture and the Italian people. As the relationship between the Sardinians and the Jews, I remember that some years ago I met Mrs. Sodju, whose husband was a respected professor in the Italian school. He used to give private lessons to young Jewish rejected from the public school due to the Russian laws. And on the eve of the Jewish razzia of July 1944, the Sojus hided the little girl of the Amati family and saved her.
So a question from me to Valerie. In a recent book, Marco Clementi and Irini Toglio, they spoke about the Italian authorities didn't like so much the division inside and the quarrel inside the Jewish community between Jews who were fascists or who were Zionists in Zionist revisionist and the other Jews. So if you can tell us something more about what happened and why the Italian authorities, government, local government, wanted to keep united, to keep the Jewish community.
So I'm not sure there's an easy answer to that question. I mean, one thing that's clear is that Zionism was, they felt it was an ideology which undermined on some level, fascist ideology. So one interesting document describes how there was one teacher who was a big supporter of Eretz Israel. And he was, you know, I don't know if he was proselytizing in class, but he had generated a small following of other pupils. And so they wanted to suppress this as soon as possible. And the interesting thing about the documentation is that the students can't understand what the problem is, because they feel that Eretz Israel is completely aligned with fascist ideals. So they see themselves as being good fascists and at the same time Zionists. They don't see these two ideologies as incompatible at all. But the regime does. And I think it really has to do with, I think that's the curious paradox of the Dodekanese, that on the one hand, there's this extension of what's happening in Italy in terms of pushing a fascist ideology on the population. So you see this extreme nationalism in the Dodekanese. On the other hand, there's always the other tension that they have to be separate. So I think the idea is that they didn't want to see any particular person in the community being more powerful than their authority.
Second question by me to both you, and there were also pro-Turkish feeling and pro-Greek feeling among the population, not the Jewish population, but the general population of Rhodes. So the Jewish group was the most how do you say? No, non lo dico. Era il più caldo, era il più hot. They had the more hot questions, matters about citizenship and future and link with somebody outside Italy, outside the island.
Le relazioni fra gli ebrei e i greci non erano sicuramente idilliache, perlomeno a Rodi, non erano buone. Lo dimostrano anche i filmati che io ho visto, insomma, Liana Picciotto può dirlo, il viaggio più lungo, dove Alberto Isale appunto racconta, no, che cosa succede a Rodi. Mentre c'era un ottimo rapporto con gli italiani, non era sicuramente così con gli ebrei, assolutamente.
I mean, in terms of the citizenship question, I think part of the problem is that there was the option for Turks to migrate and become Turkish nationals, and there was the option for Greeks to become Greek nationals, but the Jewish community had no other option but Italian nationality at that point. So I think that is part of what put a particular strain on this community. So their possibility of upsetting this hierarchy between a full Italian, Italianissimo, and just an imperial sense of Italianità. They were the most dangerous and threatening in that way. It's my interpretation.
Now we have a coffee break, and after the last
No coffee break.
No coffee break.